Get your decade ahead horoscope now at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous superstar Aries. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of August 2019, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out right now. And it is a sky that begins this month on a new moon and ends this month on a new moon as well. And even though for some, you may want to give or take a day on either side with that new moon as we start this month, still, we are starting this month on a note of fresh new beginnings. Now, some of those beginnings are going to come very much by surprise. This new moon is going to be speaking in a conversation of tension with Uranus, and that adds a certain wild card factors like things changing and yes, new beginnings, as you would see with any given new moon. However, there might be mixed feelings on our part as to how it is that we feel about it. You add to this Mercury going direct on the same day, like within the hour, some 40 something minutes later, virtually at the same time, astrologically speaking. This speaks that much more powerfully to a sense of things moving forward. And for some, it's going to be invigorating. For others, it's going to feel a little bit tense and yet refreshing all around. Now for you, this particular new moon is happening in a part of the sky that has to do with all matters of heart. What it is that you truly want, what it is that you're really passionate about, what it is that you're hoping to create, something pure within you that you desire to share. Now, of course, there's another way to understand this energy when we talk about heart, and I'll save that for the love portion of this video in just a little bit. But with this energy, a few things to keep in mind. Because this has to do with creativity, if it is that you are wanting some new opportunity and you are a person who uses your creativity to your advantage, well, this can bring some sense of a new beginning, but there may be some mixed feelings on your part as to whether or not it is the right opportunity for you. Now, if it is that you are wanting children, your fertility could take you by surprise right about now. And again, there could be some mixed feelings about that. However, the great thing is that we are progressively moving towards feeling a greater sense of ease. So whatever it is that seems like it comes up very quickly as we start this month, there will be a little bit of an adjustment before you find that groove and bigger blessings start to open up for us. And so this part of the sky is also connected to what it is that you believe is going to make you happy in life. And so for some, this could be an opportunity to have fun that ends up becoming more in depth than you had anticipated. But for others still, this is going to be a revelation, an insight where you least expected it, where you understand how it is that perhaps you've sublimated your own creative energy, your own joy energy, where it is that you haven't been taking seriously something that you feel called towards. And in honoring that, in understanding where that resistance has come from, and then honoring that desire to actually make changes in support of the things that you are passionate about in life, you will find yourself propelled on a path that feels like it more closely aligns with the truth of your heart. Now, as we navigate right in the middle of the month, right around the 15th is when we are going to have this month's full moon. We do have a powerful few days leading up to this full moon, mainly the changing of directions of power players, Jupiter and Uranus. It is going to be just days before the full moon that Jupiter goes direct, and we will also have Uranus going retrograde. Whenever a planet changes directions, its energies are that much more heightened. Now, it is Uranus that is the ruling planet of this month's full moon as well, which means what is happening with this Uranus standing still in the sky, starting to turn its energies inward, is going to be intimately connected to how you experience this full moon. Now, this full moon is happening in a part of the sky for you that has to do with friendships and groups that you belong to. It is standing across the sky from Mars and Venus as well. And of course, Uranus, as I spoke of in the Uranus special horoscope for your sign, it is Uranus slowly but surely moving through a part of the sky for you that has to do with self-esteem and self-worth and financial issues as well, money you earn and money that you spend. With this full moon connecting across the sky with Mars and with Venus, well, this is what astrologers call an opposition, which can often play itself out in terms of our one-on-one alliances, our partnerships as well can be covered here. So the full moon to me represents some sense of you taking a step back and looking more clearly, looking more closely at the people with whom you are aligned. Now for some, this is going to be an opportunity to get together with friends. And if that is the case, well, let me just say, there might be some moments where it feels like there's some mixed feelings on your part about some people within your friendship group or as part of the experience. But also, because Uranus is going retrograde and Uranus basically standing still at the same time, there might be some conversation or some talks that are financially related. If it is that you are involved in a financial endeavor with a friend or even with just a group of people, part of a group endeavor, perhaps a professional endeavor, then it is going to be some sense of needing clarity or some developments on the financial front that are going to be part of the discussion. Now, you add another layer to this, which has to do with self-esteem and self-worth. And I do think that some of your interactions now are going to have you evaluating more deeply what it is that it says about you that you have chosen to align with the particular people that you have. Now, for some, this is going to be a particularly rewarding time. Yes, even with the surprises and the insights, it could be that a friend kind of calls you on where you are in terms of self-esteem. But there's also that sense that it can also be one of those times when you're having to find a delicate way forward, understand what's right to say and what isn't to say, and to try and understand how to navigate a particular dynamic. Now, regardless of what you do choose, know that much of the answers of this full moon are going to be found by appreciating that there are different perspectives, and at the same time, having that connection to your own sense of prosperity, your own ability to create prosperity for yourself. And that may be part of where your thoughts and your contemplation and even your creativity start taking you towards. Now, we are going to end the month on a new moon. This new moon is so different than the other lunar activities for this month. It is speaking in supreme harmony with Uranus. It is happening hand in hand with Mars, not far from Venus either. There is such a sense of energy, such a sense of joy and delight at this time. And there may very well be some surprises that truly do delight. Now, this is different from the surprises as we start this month, where the energy can feel like there are that sense of mixed feelings here. But now we get to more practical matters for you. We get to a part of the sky that has to do with your daily life. It has to do with your work and the people who surround you there and the type of work that you're doing. But it also has to do with your health as well, especially in terms of health-related tests and health-related habits. And so this can be new people coming in quite by delight. This can be new work-related opportunities, new projects that you absolutely love. There's a sense of excitement as to what is changing in your daily life. And for others still, this is going to feel like a time when you feel better than you possibly have in a while, where you feel truly energized to continue to move through positive changes, whether it's with your work or with your health. And I would also say that if it is that you are hoping for some good news, a fresh slate where it comes to your health and a health-related assessment, this is a great moon to get truly great news. Now, where it comes to matters of love, that new moon as we start this month is going to set up and be part of some important energy. And so one is the fact that it's not just about this new moon, but we are also going to have for most of this month, Venus moving through the same part of the sky, this heart-oriented part of the sky. We've got Mars moving through this part of the sky for much of the month as well. And what this says is that that new moon energy isn't going to just be isolated to a moment, but rather we are going to find ways to take whatever happens and whatever may feel like a surprise and slowly but surely, steadily over the first 3 weeks of this month, bring more love, bring more passion, bring more desire into the mix. And for you in particular, given that this part of the sky has to do with flirtation and romance and what it is that you really want, as much as there is that surprise energy at the beginning of the month where it can feel like all of a sudden you're seeing things differently or you're wondering which way to go, slowly and steadily, you start tapping into the more fun, the more light, the more romantic part of this vibration. For those of you open to meeting someone new, You may have a surprise flirtation at the early days of the month. And again, there might be some mixed feelings around that. I actually think it is going to be as we navigate closer to that full moon. We're going to have a few things taking place. One is Mercury activating the eclipse that happened in this part of the sky way back in January. We are going to have, of course, Venus and Mercury in this part of the sky as well, and these two planets standing across that full moon. So I actually think that what it is that takes you by surprise in the early part of the month will eventually give way mid-month to you understanding more clearly the options that you have in love and understanding more clearly where it is that you desire to go. It is possible that you connect with someone new in the early days of the month and you're not sure how you feel about it and you have some mixed feelings for some reason. But the direction that you are meant to go in where it comes to matters of heart will start to become more clear to you mid-month. For those of you who are just getting to know someone, so if you've just started dating someone, that new moon we start the month with, that is quite the energy where you are seeing this person differently or having a different perspective. And again, there could be some mixed feelings in that regard. For a small percentage of you out there, it could be that this is a realization that you may not be wanting to continue with this person. For others of you, part of this new moon might be realized in terms of some confusion that may seem like, oh, you're getting the truth, but then maybe there are other subtleties that you are overlooking. So if it is that you're just dating someone, I would advise you try and wait until we get to the middle of the month before you make a sort of a consequential decision, if possible. And even if it doesn't seem that way, if it seems like things are moving really fast in the early part of the month, by the time we get you to the middle of the month, you're seeing things in a more balanced way. You're seeing things with a little bit of a step back, a little bit more perspective. And that will allow you to understand whether or not you truly want to be with this person, if you feel you're meant to be with this person or not. And if you are, then this is going to be a time that affirms a sense of a shared journey forward. But if it is that you aren't feeling that this person may not be the one for you, well, then that is going to become very clear and you'll be able to make your choice with a much more thorough perspective mid-month. And for those of you who are in an established bond, the energy in the first part of the month, look, again, lots of unpredictable energy here. Mercury going direct simultaneously as this new moon can be a powerful experience as well, in that you think you're realizing something or you think you know, or you're, you know, all of a sudden it's like a light turns on. And there might be mixed feelings around that because of that connection with Uranus. However, I do think that it is going to be mid-month that you're able to resolve a lot of things that might come up in the earlier part of the month. Now, what arises could be as simple as a difference in opinion. It could be a desire to do something romantic, but it doesn't seem to be coming together. Or it could be a romantic surprise that does not go as hoped. Okay, that can happen. So it's a really good idea as you're starting this month to avoid any kind of romantic surprises overall. However, as we move towards the middle of the month, it does look like you're able to gain a deeper understanding into each other and more clearly understand what took place in the early part of the month. And it is from that perspective that for some of you, you might actually be amused as you realized how different it was what you thought it might be. What I love about this month for you, well, there is a lot here, but I'm going to say that new moon at the end of the month, it is just one of the more delightful celestial occurrences that I have seen in a while. Given how this month has this kind of mixed bags with the new moon and the full moon, by the time we get to the end of the month, I think a lot of people are going to feel ready for a shift of energy. And for you, it isn't just like a shift in an ephemeral sense, but you are feeling different. You are feeling better. And that empowers you to continue to change and be excited about all the incredible possibilities ahead. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes, and so much more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.